Hi Aries, this is going to be your July 2021 reading. It's for the sign of Aries. It could be your sun, moon, or rising sign. It's a general reading, so it's not going to resonate for everyone. So hopefully it will resonate some or all. Just take what resonates and let go of what doesn't. So what we're going to go ahead and see first is the theme for the collective of Aries that I'm picking up on. What's the theme for July for Aries? So we have TikTok. So there's some kind of time constraint here. You're feeling under pressure about something getting done quickly or not getting done in time. And we all know that Aries is not one of the patient people, right? So even though we have gained some patience, there's something that you're feeling that needs to be done and it's not getting done fast enough. You're like under a time constraint here. And then we have she who is wild, savage, untamed, wild, and mysterious. So this savage here is saying, you know, you might feel like a little bit out of control. I mean, yes, Aries are kind of more of a wild spirit, like, you know, wild child kind of person. Like they're, you know, free. They're kind of a rebel. But this is a different kind of wild. This is feeling like out of control about not being able to control your destiny or your situation you're in. You're feeling kind of out of control. And then you have discontent, muses. Yeah, it's making you really feel like discombobulated, a little discontent, like not yourself. Loyalty, your reliability demonstrates your loving sense of devotion and consistency. I feel like here that Aries, you felt like you've really been diligent and loyal to a situation or person, and it just hasn't worked out for you. No matter how much you've tried and how much hard work you put in, you don't feel like you're getting the payoff. You know, like where, you know, why am I not getting anything back? I've been, you know, kind, I've been working hard, I've been doing this, you know, and I'm not getting anything to show for it here. Then we have the Queen of Wands. Well, that's you right there. Somebody that's courageous and goes after what they want. And then look at this though, we have the Emperor, which is another Aries card. Interesting, but it's upside down. So this is feeling out of your element. You're not feeling yourself. So it's kind of like against this one here. So sometimes you feel like yourself, sometimes you don't. Sometimes you feel like a completely different person. You're not standing in your power because it's just beating you down so much, right? And then we have Seven of Wands reversed. This is not standing up for yourself, feeling like you're defeated kind of. No matter how hard you try, you can't get somewhere. And then we have reflection. See all aspects of yourself through the reflection of one who mirrors your hidden self. So, you know, this is about like reflecting on who you are. I think a lot of us Aries are like reflecting on the life we've lived in, the things that's happened to us, where we are at this time, where we are going. You know, really deep sense of that. Okay, so that's the theme for you. A little confused, really reflecting to try to figure out, you know, what you have done, the mistakes you've made, the accomplishments you've made. Sorry, this Mercury retrograde, I don't know when it's going to be over, but it's just caused me a scattered mess. Anyway, so let's go ahead and see what past energies are coming into July with you, Aries. Dry desert. Yeah, see, again, feeling like, you know, left out to dry, like you don't have anything left, depleted, dehydrated, you know, just like left. And that's interesting. Yeah. Yeah. Just feeling like, you know, you're just lost where you don't know where to go in the middle of this desert, like you're in a mirage or something, you know. And then we have she who resists, fearless, justified, and restrained. So, you know, you feel like things aren't justified, like you've put all this work in and you don't see anything, you just keep getting backlash from it. And like the more you put in, the worse it seems sometimes. And then we have loss. Yeah, you're feeling some kind of loss here. And confusion. Priorities. You understand the paramount importance of manifesting love in all situations. You were trying to do this. I mean, you've been putting priorities down and maybe even sacrificing a little, but you're just not seeing anything. And you're starting to wonder, like, if this is worth it anymore, right? So then we have the Eight of Wands. This is not moving forward. You know, you're kind of like done pushing forward when it's not getting you anywhere. Not wanting to move forward, just kind of staying in this hermit mode, isolating yourself. Withdrawn. And then we have the Five of Pentacles. Yeah, see, this is this is lack mindset. This is getting out of lack mindset. You're trying to feel like you aren't lacking, but it's very hard with all this energy here. And then we have inner world. Your external world is a reflection of your inner world. So what we're feeling inside is going to manifest on the outside, even though we feel it's like vice versa. It's the outside that is making us feel that way, right? All right. Let's get some roadblocks for you, Aries. What's roadblock? What's blocking you? Metox, repairing the mind, body, and spirit. Yeah, so something might need to be purged and cleansed out. I'm getting like a lot of this negative feelings towards you having towards yourself. Like, why am I not getting there? This. But I can understand it, yeah. And this will, once you clear this up, it's going to be repaired, because this is having an effect on your mind, body, and spirit. You're feeling down, you're feeling depressed, you're not motivated to maybe exercise, you know, you're having headaches, things like that. So it's really affecting that. And then we have she who prepares, formulates, strategize and devise. So you might need to get a clear-cut plan and really stay motivated to stick to it, which is really hard when you're not in the motivation kind of way, right? And then shadow. There could be some still shadows. Something could be triggered from all this energy that's coming up now, or not getting to where you want to be. It could be triggering like your self-worth, abandonment issues, anything like that. There might be some shadows coming up, just being triggered because things aren't going the way you want them to, and you're having to wait around. Kindness, this realize, like, you know, or you are a deserving, kind person. Don't let it like jade you at all and make you a little more blunt or hasty or mad or mean to other people. This is the King of Swords. Some kind of clarity you're not seeing, some truth you're not seeing here. Page of Cups, make sure you listen to that intuition. You could be getting some information. Eight of Wands, this is moving forward. Keep moving forward. You know, it might be tough times right now, but you got to keep putting one foot in front of the other. One step's better than none. And abundance. So when your heart's intention is to serve humanity, doors of abundance naturally open. Well, see, I'm getting a lot because a lot of us Aries feel like we're on this mission. Soul mission, and we have been putting effort towards it, but we're not seeing anything back or getting confirmation. So it's really beating us down. Like, when is our abundance going to come? When are we going to get, you know, a little happiness here? Okay, so now we are going to see what possibilities are coming in. So we have inner peace. So there is a possibility of inner peace. We have she who thrives, so orchid, flourish, prosper, and blossom. So this potential is to blossom and thrive with this inner peace as well. Celebration, there will be a potential for celebration. Detachment, you're releasing old patterns. So this is releasing those old patterns of behavior and way of thinking. Letting go of things that don't serve us or toxic to us. The Moon reverse, so tapping into that intuition and letting go of our fears. Nine of Pentacles, this is our abundance and manifestation, as well as the Star, being healed and our wishes fulfilled. And then we have freedom. Follow your heart and nurture your soul with love and freedom to grow. And then we'll have that freedom. All right, so let's get some advice for you, Aries. Hangman. So really look at things in a different perspective. Don't try to like think, you know, it's your fault for anything, or, you know, you're not good enough or worthy enough. Really look at the big picture. You know, it might just be like the energy around right now or situation. Maybe you're being protected for something. Maybe it's wanting you to see something differently in a different way. Then we have the Eight of Pentacles. You know, you might have to still keep working hard a little bit. Maybe hone in on a skill. As well as the King of Cups. Get those emotions under control. Don't let them sabotage you, okay? I know sometimes Aries can go a little wild with the emotions when they're triggered. So make sure you keep them under control and master those, okay? Be compassionate towards yourself, all right? So that is your message, Aries. Thanks so much for watching. Take care. Bye.